Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. In the name of Allah, the most merciful and the most beneficent. My dear students, the topic which we are going to have that is not only important for your current class level, but it is important for every academics class. So that is how this topic will help you in future as well. Essay writing. The word essay mean attempt. So in essay writing, you attempt your thoughts in words. So you give the words to your opinion, to your thoughts, what you have about the topic. Essay writing usually starts with three main components of it. If you understand these three major parts of the essay, then you can become a good essay writer. And these main topics are the introduction, the body of an essay, and the conclusion. It is an organized piece of writing that focuses on a single topic. It is organized around a general idea or thesis. Starting off the introduction. First, we will be learning how to write a proper introduction of an essay. I'll be giving you some points as well under the subheadings of every topic. It must be very brief. It should always be interesting and interesting to the subject. It may consist of a definition, proverb, or general remark leading up to the subject. The introduction should not be in detail. You have to keep the detail for the main content, that is the body of the subject. But your introduction should be very much nicely given so that the reader should be become impressed and read your further lines. It is said that essay introduction is like a door of the whole essay. If the door is well designed, then the reader will enter the door to read it further. Therefore, the introduction of an essay is very much important. The introduction of an essay is a source to attract the reader towards to read the whole essay. Therefore, it is very much important to use a proper word in it. Besides that, I would like you to focus on the third point, that is, it may consist of a definition, proverb, or general remark. So you can add any kind of quotation as well here, or the general remark or the proverb that will help you to understand it better. So my dear students, attract the reader's attention. Begin your introduction with a hook that grabs your reader's attention and introduces the general topic. For the first passage is about the introduction of the topic as well. Let's come to the body of the subject. Here comes the main content of the topic. What you are going to write, all the information which you have collected, the selective information you will be writing in the main content. After the first paragraph of the introduction, then two or three paragraphs of the body of the subject comes. Fill your mind with fine thoughts and accurate information. The paragraph should be well constructed. The paragraphs should be related to one another. Frame your sentences so that they are quite clear and forceful. Avoid the use of unnecessary words. Fill your mind with the fine thoughts. My dear students, you should know what you have to write before you sit down to write an essay. And whatever the information you are collecting, the information should be correct. Whatever the information you are going to write, that should be correct. If you put any wrong information, it will spoil the impression of your whole essay. The paragraph should be well constructed. The paragraph should be aligned. Align in that sense, whatever you are writing, it should be correct. It should be grammatically correct. The sentences should be very much framed. The sentences should be very much organized, that what happened after this, and after this, rather than if the sentences are not in an order. The paragraph should be related to one another. one another. That means if you are talking about a particular thing, that how it emerged and what happened exactly, from where it is spreaded, then it should relate to one another. Frame your sentences so that they are quite clear and forceful. As I told you, unless or until you have mistakes in language, you have mistake in grammar, you have mistakes in writing expressions, then it will give poor impression over the reader. Therefore, frame your sentences so that they are quite clear and forceful. Whatever you are writing, make it very much clear. Whether it's a grammar error, whether it's for sentence formation, everything is important to create a proper, clear and forceful sentence. Avoid the use of unnecessary words. Last but not the least, don't try to think that if I use a very difficult vocabulary, then the reader will become impressed and my essay will be liked. No, it is completely wrong concept. You try to use the words which is understandable by everyone, and everyone can understand its meaning and can give, communicate. You can give your proper opinion through those words. To try to use those words, avoid such difficult vocabulary. The third, last important option, the important point of the essay, the conclusion. Conclusion, it should be satisfying to the reader. Sum up of the arguments of the essay. Add sentences that strikingly expresses the main points. Add a suitable quotation. My dear students, you have to make the reader satisfying. Whatever happened, although you tried to highlight some negative points, or you told any disadvantages about some topic, but you keep this thing in your mind that the reader should be satisfying. Try to end your conclusion with a very positive note. In fact, your conclusion is your chance to have the last word on the subject. The conclusion allows you to have the final say on the issue you have raised in your essay above. So, demonstrate your thoughts, importance of your ideas, and then propel your reader to a new view of the subject. It is also your opportunity to make a good final impression to the reader and to end on a positive note. Whatever happened, now we pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, everything will go fine. Like this, you can end up your topic, as you will see ahead as well. Or we have faced these circumstances, but finally we pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we can cope up with these things. So that is how you can end up your conclusion. There are few lines written. Finally, a few words that is important for your introduction, the body of the subject, and the conclusion altogether. The secret of clear writing is clear thinking, so be perfectly clear what you want to say and then write it as directly, as simply, as concisely as possible. Be direct, use short sentences, do not attempt any flowery language. But use simple words, write what you want to write with making your meaning clear. My dear students, these lines are important for three of the structures of three of the part of the essay. Your writing should be very much clear and thinking, so be perfectly clear. And as I told you, don't use flowery language, don't try to impress the other or with the high words. The words should be clear and tell what you want to say in essay. This is the main important thing. And try to be direct, don't try to make a round and then try to reaching the point. No, you just directly reach the point and say what you want to say about exactly the point, and collect the information and then put these information in words in your paper, the correct information. So these are the things which you need to be careful altogether in your three parts of the essay. My dear students, after this we have brought an essay on pandemic for you that will give you some more concept about essay, how we can write an essay. I have tried to give you an example. Following that example, I would like you to complete your assignment that will help you to write your assignment. Finally, these words are here for you. Essay on pandemic. Pandemic which we are currently facing, unfortunately. The first part is the introduction. Pandemic is an outbreak of a disease that is spread all over the world. Coronavirus is a pandemic caused by the new virus that emerged in China in December 2019. It started from the city of Wuhan. It is also known as COVID-19, Coronavirus Disease 2019. Coronavirus is named for their appearance under the microscope. The virus looks like they are covered with pointed structures that surrounds them like a corona or crown. The word corona means crown, that is borrowed from Latin. It is a contagious disease that passes from person to person through droplets from coughs and sneezes. It is considered a pandemic as it has been diagnosed in people all over the world. The spread of the virus is monitored all over the world. So this was the introduction which we have given in the first passage. Moving on to the body. The body of the essay, it is a contagious disease. This is the body of the essay. It is a contagious disease that passes from person to person through droplets from coughs and sneezes. It is considered a pandemic as it has been diagnosed possible all over the people all over the world. The spread of the virus is monitored all over the world. CDC, WHO and the health organization like John Hopkins are the leading names across the globe. Health officials are still tracing the exact source of the outbreak. Early hypothesis thought it may be linked to the animal market in Wuhan, but the study that came out in January 25, 2020 notes that the individual with the first reported cases became ill on December 1, 2019 and had no link to the animal market. Investigations are going on as to how the virus organized and spread. It appears that the symptoms are showing up in people within 14 days of emergence to the virus. In severe cases, patients feel a shortness of breath. Diagnosis at early age may be difficult with only a physical exam, because mild cases of the patient may appear similar to the flu or bad cold. Only a laboratory test can confirm the diagnosis. By far, there has been no specific treatment for the virus. The patient should be treated with supportive measures. Practicing social hygiene, respiratory etiquette, and social distancing can prevent the wrath of God. Lockdown is the biggest initiative that has been taken not only in Pakistan but all over the world. So everything you have written in the body of the language, as I told you, from where it started, what the people are doing, what is happening in the world for the coronavirus, how we can treat the patient, how we can stop this, we have mentioned in the body of the language. Moving on to the conclusion, the pandemic can be controlled by the following government orders. This is the responsibility of the patient to keep himself quarantined as soon as they find any symptoms of the virus. Being a good citizen, it has become our responsibility to follow SOPs everywhere and keep others safe from ourselves and be safe from others. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala best to us the sigh of relief from the pandemic. Ameen. Ending off the essay with a prayer, as I told you, and your conclusion with a positive note. Whatever happened, whatever the circumstances we are facing a difficult time. But we are ending with some positive thought, with a smile, that the reader, when read your conclusion, at least the reader should have a satisfied feelings. My dear students, there is an assignment given following today's lesson. You have to write an essay of 120 words on the following topics. My aim in life, my country Pakistan. I hope you will find these topics easier after understanding today's lecture. So you will be writing essay of 120 words. Yes, that is the examination requirement. I hope you like today's lesson. Thank you so much. Have a safe learning. Have a nice learning. Stay safe.